many councils which don't want to see minority, I'm not suggesting we should do that. It doesn't seem quite right that we just have continuously just one party in the morality. So I would put dissent on that and just ask that, can somebody come back to us with a positive suggestion of how we open up the system? Because it's not a party political appointment, it's an appointment above party politics. So I think it should follow that there. I say that with no disrespect to Mary or anything else. I just think there's a political principle there. But we seem to have lost our way on. Because when I've been in council for much of 41 years, it wasn't done necessarily by the ruling party. Quite often it was appointed to someone from the opposition benches as a matter of course. Yeah. So I'm not very comfortable that the current tradition is slipping into a one-party state.
Since I've been councillor, Eric, the councillor of the camp was more than what year?
14, 15. So, right, proportionality is moving from opposition councillors very soon.
Okay, what I'm going to do is hand over to the city solicitor to just explain how, if this. Oh, sorry, I don't want to put that
on. It was just to echo the comments that councillor Radford made earlier. I would have thought proportionality would have been a good principle on this topic. Thank you.
Okay, well, Councillor Hanson, in the cases.
I can understand the argument coming from the opposition that people in. There's a special reason why
because it's not, you know, within their
to, that's not a matter for this committee in terms of what happens with the Labour Party, it's not a matter for this committee. Councillor Murray.
Thanks, Chair. We would then, as Councillor Kemp said, wish us to return to proportionality, accurate proportionality, and subject to the merger of the resources of the Mayoral and Performance Select Committee, looking at high level scrutiny of Council's delivery and financial functions and the associated concerns providing value for money. The creation of strategic improvement plan advisory board to advise the Mayor and Cabinet on the ongoing work needed to effectively deliver a strategic improvement plan and to advise on the priorities within such a plan. Such board to consist of Mayor, Deputy Mayor and four opposition group leaders and to be chaired by an opposition councillor. Thanks, Chair.
So I thought, is that a comment on the item, the recommendation for changes to scrutiny, which is a different item on the agenda? I think we might make a good point that it's not what we're discussing now. So I think what we're discussing now is proportionality going into this year in the current structure. I think the discussion that we want to, you're obviously trying to get a fit to get involved in, is another item on the agenda. So
I think it does link to proportionality.
Yeah. Well, it's
probably put it in a number of places.
Yeah, there'll be a decision about proportionality when the new structure comes in, won't there? So that's, I think we need to discuss through the chair. We discuss at the moment the proportionality within the existing structure. I think it would be quite fair and reasonable to have it, and there'll be a different discussion around proportionality with the new structure. You know, if there are any changes, if there are significant changes to it.
Okay, thank you.
Just to be helpful, Chair, I'm not terribly regimental about whether we go to proportionality or not. The only two things I'd
refer to pages 80 to 97 of the agenda, which set out details of the scheme of advance allowances. Do officers wish to highlight any specific points in the report, Chris?
Thanks, Chair. Just to say, the independent powers met. I can see that a number of issues won't be bound up with, as you said, we'll do. And recommend that the council look to set up within the hours of 1.75% in line with the agreed NGC. Set out the details.